It's all a matter of genetics. With the decoding of the human genome in 2003, a new era of genetic research has dawned. Will we ever be able to stop hereditary diseases or deadly viruses? It's all just a matter of time, says this man, Thomas Tuschl. In the field of genetic research, this German biochemist is a celebrity. I think we will be able to treat at least some rare genetic diseases in the next few years. And the aim now is indeed to continue to develop drugs that will be able to switch off genes that trigger diseases. Switch off genes? Tuschl's research is centered on RNA interference, a natural protective mechanism that was first discovered in the early 90s in plants. In short, it works like this. RNA, which is short for ribonucleic acid, is a copy of the coded information in our DNA. According to these coded instructions, the building blocks of life, proteins, are produced. On the way to the factory, the instructions are checked by a guard inside the cell. If a virus is detected in one of the cells, for example, it is simply sorted out by the guard. In experiments conducted in 1998 using double-stranded RNA, American researchers Andrew Z. Fire and Craig C. Mello were able to successfully turn off specific nematode genes. But the method developed by Thomas Tuschl just a year later at the Max Planck Institute has opened up completely new opportunities in genetic research. What we knew then was that long, double-stranded RNA did not work in humans because it just killed the cells. And through our research, we found that long double strands are transformed into short ones. Then we chemically synthesized the short double-stranded ones and demonstrated that the short ones showed no side effects and could turn off genes in the human system. Tuschl's method became a scientific sensation. For the first time, the capability to switch off human genes was within reach. He patented his method, and in 2002, he founded a biotech company with some colleagues. Here in Boston, his method was refined even further into short interference RNA, RNA therapeutic, which were created in the lab and tested for effectiveness. A future market is opening. It's about totally new therapies, but it is also about potentially huge financial rewards. The next big step is to bring the active ingredient to market, which is composed of these short RNAs, and the successes there have been huge. So you can already treat certain genetic diseases whose causes are found in the liver by switching off the production of proteins. This can lead to improved function in heart and nerve diseases. Overnight, the young German rose to the level of superstar in the field of genetic research. Thomas Tuschl then followed his calling to the prestigious Rockefeller University in New York. The native Franconian has been living and researching in the Big Apple for 10 years now. New York is one of the great centers of biomedical research in the United States. Here we are surrounded by hospitals and universities. And of course, this place attracts the best and most interesting people, because people don't come here just for the research, but for the inspiration of the city as well. Laboratories around the world now use the processes that the German scientist has invented. The goal is to combat diseases that were previously considered difficult to treat. For his scientific efforts, Thomas Tuschl has now been nominated for the European Inventor Award in the category of research. This recognition means a lot to him. I'm very excited about this nomination, and the fact that it is from Europe, where I've not been in recent years, makes it that much more special. And without all of my employees, none of this would have been possible. Only time will tell if genetic research leads to better medical care. And of course, who will win the race to create better treatment options? One thing is for sure, Thomas Tuschl has qualified for the final round.